Okay, welcome to Relove Guitars. Sophie asked me to do, or suggested, could I do a quick video on guitar nuts and the problems, possible things to look out for when you change a guitar nut. So the first thing I've got to say is, I've written stuff up on the board so I can kind of point at it. So first thing to point out, the nut. Getting the nut right is the single biggest improvement you can invest in on your guitar. It'll make tuning stability incredibly much better, and it'll make the guitar easier to play because you'll get the nut slots will be nicely smoothed out, and the first fret action will be right. Okay. Now, you can't overstress that really. If you're going to spend anything, spend the time and money on your nut. And the second star point I would suggest is, if you're going to change your nut, buy a Tusq nut. Don't skimp, whether it's a Strat style or whether it's a, where's she gone? Come on. Whether it's a Les Paul style. Buy Tusq, right? These might cost you 10 quid, all right? But they're well worth investing in rather than the options, which you can get lots of different things. You can get plastic, which I don't really like. Hard, if you have to use plastic, use the really hard stuff that looks like this. Because that will cut when you come to needing to adjust the slots. Avoid soft plastic. You've got untreated bone, okay, which is kind of a yellowy colour, which cuts reasonably well. Or you've got bleached bone, which cuts reasonably well too. And that's a square one for SG style guitars, and somewhere is a rounder one, which could be for an acoustic guitar or maybe some other kind of, you can put that on a Gibson style as well. So the important thing about changing the nut slots, if you're going to change the nut, okay, there's some things that are going to challenge you. One is, when you get the nut off, you've got to make sure that this corner where it comes off, otherwise known as here, you have got to make sure this is 90 degrees, so the wall of it is straight down and this shelf bit here is 90 degrees. Often when the nut comes off, it isn't that. Okay, so you have to find a way of doing it. Now, if you get a sandpaper to it, you end up kind of grinding all of this down. It's very, very difficult to get this perfectly square. So two things I've invested in to make sure I get it exactly right. One is a fine chisel, which I can use. If it's a Les Paul, I can use it to, if I want to, kind of go along here. But even then, you aren't guaranteeing that it's flat. You can use, it's very good for that chisel. It's very useful for cutting downwards to get rid of glue off the face of this and making sure that corner is 90 degrees. And when you kind of get right down up close to it and look across there, you'll be able to pretty much see, if you put it up against something, you'll be able to see where that's 90 degrees and where there's a little bobble in the corner there which will stop the nut seating. So that kind of chisel is very handy. The second thing that I've been wanting for ages and never got around to buying is this little thing here. It's called a Hosco. It's got a name. It's the TLSF3, and it's a two files, one on each end of this thing. It's a block of metal, steel, iron, whatever, and it's designed to go into a fret slot and allow you to rub up and down. Now, it's designed to fit perfectly in a Strat slot. It's exactly 3 millimeters wide, so that will go in your typical Strat slot, but it also will work here. You just have to be a bit careful how you use it up against this edge. So there's a bunch of possibilities for Les Paul style nut changes, including if you've got some custom spacing, you can make your own from a bone blank. So these kinds of things, bone blanks and these unbleached and bleached nuts, I buy them in bulk from China. They're no different from what somebody in the UK will be selling you for a fiver, but you'll get five of these for a fiver from China. They'll take a while to arrive. You have to be prepared. What I do more and more now on these guitars is I use my version. Either, if a customer wants a solid nut, as mentioned, I will use the solid form of Tusq nut. Okay, I won't use anything but Tusq these days. And more on the Gibson style guitar, I will use this cunning Tusq nut insert, which I will build or make a base for it in resin, and that will end up going up and down. And I do that actually, that kind I do for Gibson style, but I also do a version for that looks a bit like this for Strats, and they really do work. But that's my end of things. Obviously, you aren't going to necessarily be able to do that because you have to drill and tap little screw holes. So back to the drawing board. Main thing is when you put a new nut on, it has to have 90 degrees. It's got to fit to the end of the fingerboard, and you need the strings to come up the nut in a slope. So the slots have to be cut sloping. Even if the nut is not sloped, the nut has to slope, or sorry, the slots have to slope. And so there's a kind of launch point that has to be at the front of the nut. You need that pressure of the string to be touching there, and then it to come off cleanly from there. And ideally, your target is to make that your strings go over the first fret at 0.3 millimeters. So your challenge there is you've got to clean up the slot, get it 90 degrees and flat. Like I said, that's the big challenge. Okay, so pulling out here, we've got a 3D picture. And what you can see is a typical string on most guitars come in of a plastic or even bone nut. There's a low E string, and you can see there's its shadow. Oops, blur it. There's its shadow over the nice shiny fret. And you can see in my drawing, straight up distance between the string and its shadow is often as high as 0.8 millimeter, sometimes even a millimeter. Anything above 0.5, right, particularly on the first frets, is going to go sharp when you fret the note on the first or second frets. And that will make playing in tune very difficult. Even if the tuning is solid, playing in tune will always sound out when you play a mixture of open and fretted strings down around the nut. So what you have to do is you have to get this string down further into the nut so that it passes over the fret, first fret at 0.3 instead of 0.8 that it's doing here. And what I recommend you do is you file downwards using, you can get expensive nut files, but my ebook shows how to do it with a £1 jeweler's file, a V-shaped file. You really need to, and you can see here I've given you the dotted line, shows how it opens up the slot, but it also creates a notch at the bottom, and you can round that out with, there are some very inexpensive kinds of file substitutes that you can buy, or even an old string pulled through there will help round that out. Actually, in fact, I found that the slots that you make with these jeweler type files actually play okay as they are, but they are potentially sharper than you'd want, so you want to find something to round those out. And that's a totally budget way of doing it. A set of proper nut files can cost you anything from 70 to 110 quid. So my ebook, just a little plug there, shows you how to do this with the cheapest file, the £1 jeweler's file, and save you a fortune. So I've discovered over the years it's easier, once you've put a nut in place, it's much easier to cut down to the precise first fret action that you want, not that one, than it is to try and cut upwards from the bottom. Often people think about, I'm going to sand it away from the bottom. The reason it's easier to cut down is you can take the string out, cut a little bit more with your file, and then check the distance and stop when you've got it right. The downside of doing it that way is you get slightly rougher nut slots. Now with Tusq, that isn't a problem because it's such a good lubricated material. Even with a file, the V file, cheap V file, you'll get a playable nut slot that will not have any friction, and it will be great for tuning stability. And give you that first fret action you're after. Other people try and do it from the bottom upwards. I found through experience the downside of that, it's very nice because you leave the original factory slots untouched, especially if it's Tusq, it's the perfect condition, but I have found it's almost inevitable you'll oversand it and it'll be too low. You can't get this precision by sanding up because you're sanding up on a block, on a bench, and you're having to put it back on, put all the strings back on, check which side is perfect, which is higher, and then you go back to sanding on a block. This way, you're watching the string. If you're coming downwards from above, you're watching the string cutting down, and you know when to stop. And that's 10 quid a time, or you have to shim the thing, and then you'll probably overcut it again, you have to shim it again. Anyway, so as I said before, I tend to now use adjustable Tusq nut inserts. These were developed for a Gibson, for a problem that Gibson had with its zero fret nut, actually, and Graftech cleverly jumped in and offered a solution. And as soon as I saw these, I thought I could use those. So I make a, I if you see from side on, it looks like this. Ta-da. Okay, sort of a slight rise up from left to right. You can see that coincides with the nut thickening at the front from the back. Here it is there. That's the adjustable bit at the top. It's got a grub screw going through it, and there's a base it stands on. And the, sorry, it's got a little foot, and the foot sits on the inside of this base that I make for it. Now, what I do is I sand this base bit down so the whole thing sits in there. Ideally, we get it to fit with the strings touching the first fret, because then we can dial in the grub screw and lift the nut part, this part, the adjustable part, out of the bass to give the perfect action, adjustable, dialed up to give the perfect action. And that, because we don't, and this is a test nut, so I have messed around with the slots here, but typically on one that I do on a customer's guitar will be a new one, which I have a pile dangling up here in the rafters with all my other supplies. The nut slots, so the perfect situation is to have unfiled Tusq material slots, which give you the perfect tuning stability, and then with this coming up to the perfect height, you get the perfect first fret action. Okay, so I've kind of covered all the things I wanted to cover. I'm trying to keep this on. Well, it was supposed to be 10 minutes, but it failed. So coming back to the beginning, the nut, single most important investment. What you want is you want clean, non-friction-free slots, okay? And you want the perfect first fret action. That will give you half of your tuning stability. The other half, by the way, is the slack that you need to stretch fully out of your strings when you change strings. That slack plus the nut will mean you'll never go out of tune again. You get those two bits right, your tuners have nothing to do with it, and anyone who says they do is talking out their ears. The other part is don't skimp on this nut when you're gonna if you're gonna change it for a Tusq one. And you know, I'm talking about the adjustable ones, but I would recommend you use a £10 Tusq nut for whichever guitar. Get it in place with the right angles, get it seated perfectly. It's going to be way too high to begin with, mostly, and then use the V notch file, or if you've got nut files, great, use them, but use the cheap V notch file, and you can get my ebook if you want to see how to do that, and then come down until you've got the perfect first fret action. Okay, Sophie did ask to talk about the things that could go wrong. I think I mentioned a couple of them. One is that you try to flatten this out with various different methods, and you end up cutting further this way, so the shelf goes further, or you go deeper in down that way and you get a slope and you have to cut it and it becomes deeper and deeper. You can mess this up. So if you're going to do this, if you haven't already got a nice clean shelf here from the previous nut, I recommend something like this. This was about 25 quid, it wasn't cheap. Or you get a thin scalpel that you can do, get that 90 degrees right. Sometimes if you've really got nothing available to you, I take a piece of metal ruler and I double-sided sticky tape some sandpaper. This one needs changing, but even that in there, held very still, will give you a better result than nothing, okay? Getting the nuts off is the only thing I haven't talked about. Normally they're super glued in. What I tend to do, and people kind of look at me in horror sometimes, I get a piece like this and I hold it down there like that, and I bash this in gently with a rubber hammer until you can see, and you do it very gently, and you usually see it start to go like that, and then you can usually just wiggle it and it'll come off. If you're doing it to a guitar that's a nut that's in a slot, okay, you can sometimes get it loose, right? But if you keep pushing, you'll either break the rosewood behind there if it's a Strat, or you'll sometimes break the paintwork that's risen up over this original nut. And basically, once you've got it moving at all, you need to just find ways to wiggle it out and get it out without breaking anything else. But sometimes you can't avoid it. And I always say that even if, for example, a guitar has a plastic, hard plastic nut on there, if I can get the right first fret action and this thing is not pinging and holding friction and stopping the strings moving, causing them to struggle to be in tune, I'll go on the if it ain't broke, don't fix it. I don't change it out for a Tusq one just for the hell of it. If this thing, even if it's made of bread, you know, if this works, then I will get the priority is getting the first fret action, and I'll live with that, even if it's made of something I find offensive. Okay, if it's working, don't break it. But you working equals the right action here and no friction when the string goes through. Okay, I kept it to 15 minutes. I'm amazed that I even managed to do that. Hope that was helpful. Sam in Real Love Guitars. Catch you again soon.